It was quite a surprise, I must admit. So, I mean, he was the reason that I started playing chess. I knew the moves beforehand, but actually the Fischer-Spassky match was really what got me interested in the game. So I wouldn't be doing what I am today if not for Bobby Fischer. So, you know, it's just sad to hear.
Okay. So he was actually your youth idol?
Well, not exactly, because I couldn't really stand his behavior. I mean, even as a seven-year-old, I didn't understand why everybody in the West thought he was so wonderful. But as a chess player, I very much appreciated him. You know, Fischer's 60 Memorable Games is one of my earliest books. My grandmother bought it me for Christmas, and I remember I played through it many, many times. You know, it's a well thumbed volume. So,
the reason you've always been an E4 player, maybe?
I don't know. I think people tend to play E4 anyway. It's a logical move, you know. It opens the diagonals for the bishop and the queen, and D4 doesn't give you quite so much freedom. So I came to this quite logically.
No, but at some point you could just decide to copy openings from great players, such as many players do. But
yeah.
Okay. And well, maybe one specific thing you think you really have learned from studying his games.
I'd say that Fischer was it was something very direct, very logical about his chess, and there's nothing mysterious.
Okay.
But you know the. His games are really not difficult to understand, but who else could play like this? You know, this is the problem. You look at them afterwards and you think, ah, yes, well, it's all completely obvious, isn't it? It's always obvious afterwards. When you're sat there, you don't find the ideas.
Okay.
All right.